Hello, everyone. Thanks for tuning in. We provided an overview of the usage summary in another video. That's the reporting dashboard that you're seeing here. For now, what I'd like to do is highlight the download usage section. Within the download usage section, you have access to more detailed reports that provide more granular information on your Azure costs and usage. You have a few different options in terms of how you downloaded the data. You have the monthly report download. Here you'll notice there's actually a few different reports that you can download, starting with the balance and charge file. The balance and charge file essentially will contain high-level information on your overall cost and usage. So if you click back over to the usage summary, the balance and charge file pulls the data that you're seeing here at the top right of the usage summary, and it's basically capturing the beginning balance, new purchases if you had any, adjustments, as well as the ending balance and a breakdown of the commitment, usage, the service overage, charges billed separately, as well as the total Azure Marketplace charges for your entire enrollment. So again, the balance and charge file gives you a monthly view of the high-level information, total cost, and usage across all of the different accounts and subscriptions within your enrollment. The usage detail file contains a more granular breakdown, and it actually gives you a day-to-day view of your entire cost and usage that you can filter down into a particular account, subscription, all the way down to a particular resource group, even a tag that you have created through the Azure portal. We'll take a look at this file in detail in just a moment. You also have a breakdown of your marketplace charges. The marketplace charges file basically gives you a month-over-month view of your total marketplace consumption for any months with metered marketplace services. So you'll notice here there's a few blank months. That indicates that there was no metered marketplace charges within those months. Fixed monthly marketplace charges are only shown in the usage summary. You also have access to the price sheet. You'll notice there is a current up-to-date price sheet available within a tab here, but you also get a historical month-by-month view of the price sheet in case any prices have changed. The price sheet lists out every single Azure service, as well as the corresponding cost of that service, and it does include any discounts you have negotiated through your EA. It is available here for download for reconciliation purposes. Now, as discussed, I'd like to take a deeper look at the usage detail file. Again, this file contains details on all of the cost and usage from all of the different accounts and subscriptions you have created through your Azure Enterprise portal. When the file is available, of course, you'll notice you have the icon to click here. You can select Open. I already have it opened here. I'm just going to open this up. This is the file that appears, and this is a breakdown of the month of April. So actually everything from the 1st through today, April 23rd. And you'll notice at first the file is very large and unwieldy, but I'll prove some quick and easy insights on how you can digest this data. You'll notice row 3. It contains all of the column headers, and actually I'm going to expand these to take a quick look. You'll notice, of course, you get a day-to-day view of the usage from every single account. You can filter down a particular account, or of course, you can filter by the account owner email address, as well as any particular subscriptions within those accounts. If you wanted to isolate a particular day as well, you can certainly do so. Now, the most important columns are probably these here. You'll notice the meter category. That's going to highlight the high-level service that was deployed. You'll notice QRNS, the consumed quantity, the rate, as well as the total cost. Then, of course, here's the individual service, in column N. The extended cost is simply the consumed quantity times the rate, and you'll notice if you highlight the full column, you'll see the total usage to this point in the month, $21,037 displayed down here at the bottom. Excel gives us the sum. Now again, that's showing us total usage across all of our different accounts and subscriptions. You'll notice if you scroll further right in the file, you have the option to filter down a particular tag or resource group from the Azure portal. You can also filter to a particular department and cost center if you have those set up within the Enterprise portal. The data is much more digestible if you utilize a pivot table. What I'm going to do is configure a quick and easy pivot table as an example here. To start, I'm going to delete those two empty rows at the top of the file so that my Excel workbook starts with just the relevant columns and the data underneath. Now, very simply, I hit Insert Pivot Table, and now I'm able to set up the rows, the values, and the filters that I want to view. So to start, I may wish to see the cost by account. I want to list my accounts as my rows, as well as the extended cost as the value. Now, I'm seeing a breakdown in the month of April, April 1st through the 23rd. The total cost associated with each individual account, of course, the grand total, reflecting what we saw in the Excel file earlier, $21,037. I can add a filter if I wanted to isolate a particular day within the month. I can also remove my account name as my row and add in. Let's say if I wanted to get a breakdown of the cost by resource group. This is every single resource group that is created within every subscription in the month of April. I can now go back to my accounts and add the account as a filter here. So if I wanted to see the resource groups tied to a particular account, or I can do it by subscription as well. So I'm going to remove accounts and add subscriptions as a filter. So now I can see all of the different subscriptions associated with my account. I can filter down to an individual subscription to take a look at the resource groups and the resource group cost within those subscriptions. I can also replace resource group in the row value and add in subscriptions. Now, of course, I'm getting a breakdown of that $21,037, but this time by subscription. These are some quick and easy pivots to help you digest the data. You can, of course, play with the fields here. There is a large amount of data that we can filter and pivot on within this file. Coming back to the Enterprise portal, I also want to provide a quick overview of the Advanced Report Download feature, as well as the other tabs that you see here. The Advanced Report Download is very similar to the Usage Detail file that we just looked at, but instead of getting a monthly view of every single account tied to my enrollment, I can create my own date range. So if I wanted to look at, let's say, Q1 of 2018, January 1st through March 31st, I simply select the date range, and I also select the accounts I wish to view usage on. Now I will select one of the accounts. When I select Request Usage Data, it'll load here on the right side and let me know when the data is available to download. I see all the historical reports that I've downloaded. The most recent one is still processing. It's important to note that this does not update automatically. You need to select Refresh, wait a few seconds, and you'll notice the data is available to download. This account happens to be empty during the time frame I specified, so it's telling me there is no data. But you'll notice when there is data available within the date range within this account, you have the option to download the file here. There's also an API access key. The API access key is here, and it enables Enterprise Azure customers to programmatically pull consumption and billing data into a preferred data analysis tool. One great example of how the API key works is with Power BI. Power BI is another Microsoft product. It's actually a data reporting tool, a data visualization tool, that allows you to build custom dashboards and custom reports in case you're looking for data that isn't displayed within the usage summary, or even just a different view of the data that is displayed within the usage summary. The page here provides you instructions on how to configure the Power BI environment. If you scroll into the Help section, you'll notice there are more detailed steps available as well. It is very easy, though. You simply navigate to the Microsoft Azure Consumptions Insights page. Here we are. One thing to note, I'm already logged in. The system will require you to log in with a valid work or school account, and it'll ask you to enter in your enrollment number. The enrollment number can actually be found here at the top left of the Enterprise portal. It's also found on the Enrollment Detail page that Enterprise administrators have access to. From there, you select the months you wish to go back and pull data from. I'm going to select the previous quarter, 3 months, next. Now, while this is loading, I'm going to come back into my reporting section and go ahead and pull my API key that I need to enter, paste into Power BI, and that's what essentially pulls the data from the Enterprise portal into the external tool Power BI. If there is no key here, of course, you simply select Generate. The system will generate a key. One important thing to note is the effective date of the key. The keys are valid for 6 months, and at that point you will need to regenerate a key. A secondary key is also available. I have a key generated. I'm going to expand and copy the key and paste that into Power BI here. Now that I've pasted my API key into the Power BI window, I can click into the report, and now this is the default dashboard that's created using the data that's pulled from the Azure Enterprise portal. And here we see the total cost, $21,037, that we saw in the Excel file just a moment ago. Now this is the default dashboard that is created. It's important to note that you can, of course, build your own custom dashboard using the tools available within Power BI. What you'll need to do is select the down arrow here next to My Workplace and click into the Microsoft Azure Consumption Insights data set. Once you click into the data set, you'll notice the different tabs of the reporting dashboard that are available here. I'm going to expand the usage details, and I have the ability to pull the data into the white space here and configure my own dashboards. So very simply, I started with the account names. I'm going to build a quick dashboard that shows cost by account. I pulled in the account names, and very simply, I will come over here again to my extended cost. This is my cost data that I will simply drag and drop into the account view. Now I'm getting a quarterly breakdown over the past 3 months of the total cost of my Enterprise Azure environment, broken down by all the different accounts within my Azure Enterprise portal. Now you can configure this data further and add visuals. Again, very simply, you drag and drop the visual over the dashboard, over the data you wish to view it with. And now, for instance, I have a pie chart, which shows total costs broken down by all the individual accounts within my Azure Enterprise portal. This is a very basic report. You can configure this further using the data that's available to you within Power BI that is connected to the Azure Enterprise portal via the API key. Now, that concludes the deep dive around the download usage section. Thank you very much for watching. We appreciate the support.